got to be metallic color from Schwarzkopf. I wanted to get something that would really complement my dark hair, that would go with it nicely, and that would show up really beautifully. So I went with something a little bit more deep, and I just love the amethyst purple color. I think it is so pretty. I also wanted to keep in mind that they needed to show up on these extensions. So I have blonde ombre extensions, and I wanted this to be predominantly like really purple at the bottom, very amethyst and bright. So I went with this one, and as you can see, it worked out great. But just be mindful when you're picking out your color, what you think will look best with your hair, what will suit your hair best. I totally think that the amethyst looks really beautiful on dark hair. And I'm gonna have it linked down below as well, where you can purchase it and all the details on that. So if you're curious about it, I will have it down in the description box below. So in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you guys how you can add color to ombre tip extensions. Or if you have ombre hair, this is a really easy way to take dark hair with a little bit of lightness at the bottom into a beautiful amethyst chrome look. So once you've found your color, you can start your hair transformation. It is really easy. So the first thing you want to do is go ahead and grab your box. So this box has everything in it that you need. You need nothing more than just this. And you can find the Got to Be Metallics at Walmart. If you have thicker hair like myself, or if your extensions are very thick, you are definitely gonna wanna use two boxes of hair dye to properly coat the extensions or the hair completely. It is better to have a little too much than to have too less. So I definitely recommend two boxes if the hair is very thick. Inside the box, you're gonna find your applicator bottle, and this contains the developer. You're also gonna find your color cream, which you're gonna add to the developer. There is a color after treatment, and you can apply this just like you would a conditioner as you're washing your hair and rinsing out the dye. This is gonna make your hair feel really soft, really silky, and it's gonna lock in that color and make it nice and vibrant. You're also gonna have a set of gloves, which you will totally need when you're dyeing the hair. You don't wanna get any of this dye on your hands, and this is gonna help protect your hands from the hair dye. You're also gonna have a little info packet inside that has a step-by-step list of steps you can follow when you're dyeing your hair with the Got to Be Metallics. I also wanted to mention, while you're in store trying to pick out your color, there is actually a tips and tricks area right at the bottom of the box, and it has different hair colors that you can reference. Whether you're like me with dark brown hair, you can see the color result there, or if you're blonde, you can see the color result here, so you can kind of see what color your hair will look like after you dye it. Also wanted to mention that the color is very on point, so whatever you pick out, that is what you're gonna get. It is not lighter, it is not darker, it is exactly this color, which I love. So you wanna go ahead and pop on your gloves, because we're gonna get into mixing, and you wanna protect your skin from any of the hair dye. So the first thing you wanna do is grab your applicator bottle. You're gonna unscrew the top of the bottle, and you're going to place the color cream inside. So you're gonna wanna take the cap of the color cream, and you want to pierce it into the bottle so it creates a hole. It'll make it really easy for you to squeeze all of the color cream into the developer bottle. So you wanna make sure you empty the color cream tube into the bottle completely. Once you've properly emptied the color cream into the applicator bottle with the developer, you're gonna wanna shake it. So make sure you apply the cap back on nice and tightly and give it a good shake until the mixture is even. And what I mean by even is you wanna make sure that the developer and the color cream are evenly mixed together to where you don't see any separation. When the color cream and developer are mixed together, they're gonna look very, very light, almost like there's no color at all. But as time goes on and as you are dyeing the extensions, the color is going to darken. It's gonna go from a clear to a pink into the amethyst color as its final stage. So you're gonna wanna make sure that your extensions are brushed out completely so there's no knots, you can properly place the dye into the hair evenly. You wanna protect your surface area with a towel or possibly something like saran wrap, like I have here. This is gonna protect the area from being stained with hair dye, and make sure you're wearing some clothes you don't mind messing up, or just be really careful not to get any hair dye on your clothes, it will stain. Now what I like to do is apply the hair dye to the middle area of the hair and bring it downwards. I wanna make sure the ends are coated completely with this dye so there is no patchiness. And while you're spreading it out, make sure you spread the hair in the center, and make sure you coat the center as well, because you wanna make sure that this color is all over the hair and there is no splotchiness. Make sure the extensions are completely coated in the dye. You don't want any dry patches on it. You want it to be completely covered in hair dye to get the full effect and the full amethyst color. This is gonna make everything super even, so make sure you're really blending the dye into the extensions really thoroughly and taking your time with it, because the more time you take with blending, the more smooth and beautiful this color is going to be. There's so many strands of hair in your hair and also in extensions, that it's easy to miss a spot. So make sure that you are separating the hair out and blending the dye in. When you're applying it at first, you'll notice all the shimmer and kind of glistening pearls in the dye. It is really beautiful. It looks like strawberry milk. I think it's gorgeous. And you'll notice that it gives a metallic finish. It's almost like an eyeshadow or liquid eyeshadow. It's so gorgeous. At first, I started to coat the blonde area, but I ended up going all over the extensions, coating them with the amethyst shade because I really wanted to give a vibrant look. So I just went ahead and coated the top all the way to the bottom of the extensions. As I am really blending and working the dye through the extensions, I'm kind of rubbing my hands together and making sure I wiggle the dye all the way to the end of the hair. So here you can see I've coated the extensions completely and thoroughly from root to tip with the Got to Be Metallic color. So now I'm gonna let that sit for 30 minutes. The longer you wait, the deeper the color. So remember that you wanna wait full time if you want the true color that you see pictured on your box. So after 30 minutes is up, you can rinse the extensions, rinse the hair out completely. And I like to give it a really good shampoo. I shampoo it twice until all of the dye is pretty much off of the extensions. And then I'll go in with the color treatment. So this is really nice after you've dyed hair. This is gonna restore the smoothness and the softness of the hair. It's gonna condition it nicely. And it's also gonna protect the color. This stuff is holy grail. I wish that they made color treatments like this in a big bottle because it is so good. And after you've rinsed the extensions, you can go ahead and let them air dry, which is what I usually do, or you can round brush them, kind of blow dry them straight, and then proceed to styling. So with these, I actually did blow dry them, and I went in with the curling iron after to really give them a nice body wave. So we're gonna go ahead and pump up the volume. I love using hair care products from Got To Be to really make this hair big, beachy, and voluminous. I love big hair. So first we're gonna go in with a dry shampoo. This is called Fresh It Up, and I have it in the tropical scent. I like using dry shampoos not only to refresh the hair, but we're gonna use it to really add tons of volume to the root area. So typically my hair falls a little flat at the root, so I like to apply the Fresh It Up right at the root area and kind of swish it around a little bit. I'm just gonna take the dry shampoo and I'm gonna start to place it into the root area, and then I just like to kind of tousle the hair a little bit, and it really makes it so much more full. So I'm just taking it, separating the hair, and then tousling it a little bit. I like to take the Fresh It Up and apply it right at the back crown area of my head. That's usually where my hair is the most flat. I'm gonna flip some hair over it, and then I'm gonna make it nice and big in this area. I also wanted to mention that using Fresh It Up is really gonna help those extensions hold tightly to the hair because it takes away any oil and refreshes. It's going to make it super easy for those extensions to clip on, stay on, and they're not gonna slip because your natural oils are gonna be nice and refreshed with this product. So next we're gonna go in with the Mesmerizing Texturizing Hairspray. And what I like about this is it gives a natural finish. It's not crunchy, it's not too hard or rough on the hair. It is actually very natural and soft, and it's gonna add lots of texture and kind of give it a beachy look. So if you're into messy, textured, beachy hair, you will really love this product. I just like to spritz it through the center area of the hair, so right in this region. You definitely don't want to apply this too close to the top of the hair, or else it's going to make it look a little too messy up there. You want to kind of add that fun down to the lower half of the hair. Because you still want it to look good. You don't want it to look too messy, but you want it to look kind of tousled towards the bottom. And when I spray it in like that, I just like to take the hair and grab it from the bottom and just kind of scrunch it upwards. All right, you guys, so this is the final look using the Schwarzkopf Got To Be Metallic color, and I am so in love with this amethyst color. It is really, really beautiful. At first, I thought it was gonna be more of a lighter purple, but it's actually really true to the box picture. So it is a nice, deep amethyst purple. It's really magical. It has like this kind of three-dimensional tone to it. And when I was applying the dye to the extensions, I could see all these pearls and shimmers. Super shiny and glittery the dye was, and it was like really pretty. So I could totally see that on these hair extensions. They have a look to them. As I move around, you can see that there is somewhat of highlights in them. So this dye is gonna add so much dimension to your hair, as well as give it this really fun amethyst color if you go with this shade. But I am really pleased with it. I think it looks so good, especially with the dark hair. I just love it. I think it's so pretty. So if you guys want to find out more about these Got To Be Metallic colors, I'm going to have them linked down below in the description box. And let me know if you end up trying these. I'm so curious if you guys will do the amethyst or try another color. They're so fun and I am really tempted to do a bully next. So I'll keep you posted. If you did like this video, don't forget to like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And I hope the rest of your week is absolutely amazing. I will see you in my next tutorial.